Corvette didn't work out because it broke the gas line. So Jake lent us, it's beautiful 2003 Mercury Grand Marquis. Belonged to Bernard Julius Finestone. He was a war vet.
So mazel tov, actually, I was listening yesterday. You had 15 years at the station.
15 years, yeah. I would never have thought 15 years. Never.
Because I'll be 60 in 3 years. So I do not. I've always said I do not want to be in a press box in my 60s.
But you guys are super involved in the community too. So it's, I mean, you've understood that engagement today is actually being part of the story, not just broadcasting at people.
Yeah.
But you grew up with radio in your house. Like that was, that's your...
Yeah, it was under my pillow. Like literally under my pillow. I always believed in the intimacy of radio as an art form, and we've proven that, I think we're a good case study.
Model yourself after anything?
No.
But you have to protect your sources, and too many people in the media don't understand how the landscape has changed, and everybody knows a lot now. The average fan knows a lot, right? Because if they take the time, they're really consumed by information. Mm-hmm. You have to be careful. The information that you put out there, fans can figure out who your source is very easily.
Mm-hmm. So
when you've been around as long as I have, very often people will come to you with stuff.
Well, that's interesting about your profile. You have a reputation of being a person of integrity, and obviously you back it up. Like, I'm nobody in the community, and you're choosing to do this. And we have that tax, though.
That's what people said about the Canadians, too. Same thing. People don't want to play here because of the taxes. And then one summer, Bob Gainey signed 10 free agents.
Yes.
How did that happen? You don't overpay. You add another year to the contract.
Give away Ryan McDonough.
Well, that was stupid.
That was brutal. It's a strange move. Didn't really understand that.
I always wondered what Trevor Timmons, the director of scouting, like his reaction. I would have loved his reaction when they said we have to trade McDonough.
You seem to have a real friendship with Bill and with Chris. It seemed like such...
Well, they're both extremely intelligent. Two of the smartest people I've ever known. And, you know, they big hearts, and I love Nylon. Chris hates it when you call him Nylon. Knuckles are Chris.
Right.
And don't ever hit him in the back of the head. But I was aware of what he did for kids going to the children's hospital on his own time. Mm-hmm. You know, who does that?
Right.
Without any recognition needed. That's just he felt compelled to do it because of his position. And Chris's story, to know what happened to him and how bad it got, I always said, geez, if there's any way I can help him, considering all the help he provided me in terms of a fan and a paying customer through the years, how he carried that team on his shoulders by protecting it.
And
it's interesting that both have had movies made, both have had documentaries made about them, and both are having Hollywood movies made.